My name is Jeff Hickman. I'm a senior sales engineer with SecureAuth. Today I'm here to talk to you about Office 365. Why are we talking about Office 365? Well, it's one of the fastest growing SaaS applications in the marketplace for business productivity. In fact, it's edging out one of the traditional leaders of SaaS applications, Salesforce, to become the absolute fastest growing application that a lot of businesses are adopting. The specific reason that we wanted to talk to you was around authentication and allowing users to have access to Office 365. It presents a real challenge for a lot of organizations, especially when it comes around ease of use. How do we secure our authentication while not burdening our users unduly? Well, that's where SecureAuth comes in. We're able to use our best-of-breed adaptive authentication to change the authentication structure as the user goes to authenticate. When users are leveraging SecureAuth and organizations are authenticating users through SecureAuth to Office 365, whether that be any of the applications therein, such as Outlook, or maybe OneDrive, or maybe other applications beyond there, such as SharePoint or whatever else you may have, we federate the access from Office 365 into SecureAuth. SecureAuth then becomes the central authentication point. This means that you can manage all of your authentication policies from one place, rather than having to manage them in Office 365 and maybe Active Directory, but we bring them all into one place for you. So when a user goes to request authentication, whether it's through the mobile app, maybe it's through the thick client on their device, like the Word client or the Outlook client, all of that is handled via SecureAuth through federation with Office 365. Microsoft has done a great job of enabling something they call modern authentication. Modern authentication allows us to have a web-based rich context when we go to authenticate any of these clients. So when a user goes to request access to an Office 365 site, they'll be redirected to SecureAuth, and this is where the magic happens. This is when we're able to look at the context of how that user's authenticating, the posture of where they are in the world, the device they're using, and other details about them before we even get to prompting them for a second factor or bogging down their standard workflow as they're proceeding with their busy day. What is adaptive authentication? Well, we have a number of other videos that go really into depth about adaptive authentication, but just in a nutshell for you, we'll look at things like their geolocation, the velocity of their login. We'll look at the threats associated with their IP to say, hey, the IP address is coming from a Tor exit node or some sort of anonymous login. We'll look at all that information, as well as their device posture, and as well as the group membership that they may have inside of the applications and that you've dictated that they gain access to. When we look at all that information, one of the nice parts about what we can do is change the authentication story on the fly. So a user may log in that morning from the office. You know that's in an approved geolocation. You saw their last login was last night from the office before they left to go home. You know the IP address is good because it's coming from your subnet or your public IP address. You know their device is legitimate because it's part of your organization. It's a work-issued device. Why are we prompting for second factor in this case? Why are we adding a burden onto our end user who may, if they get too frustrated, might turn to, Dropbox instead of using OneDrive to share files. Or maybe they'll turn to their personal Gmail address to email that client that really important quote that they're trying to get out. All that is burden in front of the user when they're trying to gain access to their application set. So adaptive allows us to really focus on the context and when the user is going to authenticate to change that. If they do violate a rule, then that's the point in time where we could ask them for a step-up authentication with two-factor, whether that's a mobile, maybe push notification to their device, maybe it's a SMS, or maybe even it's a time-based OTP that we send that we ask the user to put in. All those are allow the user to have an easy method of two-factor authentication, but only when it's necessary, only when they violated some sort of adaptive rule. The nice part about Office 365 and the integration with SecureAuth is that it is all native to the modern authentication screens, but additionally, we can also support the WS Trust context for things like your native Android or native iOS mail clients. So we can fully support the Office 365 authentication scenario. Now you may be asking, okay, that's great, yeah, two-factor, why is it so important? Well, one of the large things that we've been tracking over the past couple years, and the main reason why SecureAuth exists is to prevent the misuse of stolen credentials. And we've seen out of the Verizon data breach report, the 2016 report said 63% of data breaches included some sort of stolen or weak passwords. The recent data breach report from 2017 said, 81%. So we've seen a climb, about a 28 to 29% climb in data breaches around stolen or weak passwords. By putting adaptive authentication and two-factor authentication in front of your Office 365, which may contain, you know, really sensitive data for your organization, that allows you to not worry so much about the password, maybe take a back seat to it to allow the context and the two-factor to take over. In fact, if you really wanted to, something that we are really excited about is enabling passwordless authentication into Office 365. With this context, with the mobile push method of second factor, we can remove the password from the equation and allow the user to simply put in their username and then get a message to their mobile device, provide their fingerprint via Touch ID, and boom, they're logged right into Office 365 at that point. We know that two-factor alone isn't enough. We know that passwords are a real point of concern for a lot of organizations and how a lot of data breaches happen. So by combining all of our layers, by allowing us to use their mobile device for interactions, SecureAuth can provide a really robust and complete solution for securing access to Office 365. Thank you for your time today. I hope you tune in the future.